Hey everybody, welcome to my channel. My name is Iris and I help people bring more love into their lives from the inside out. And today we are talking about why it's not such a great idea to relationship jump after leaving a significant relationship. One of the biggest mistakes I made several years ago after the end of a significant relationship for me was to fill that void and so that I didn't have to feel the pain of a relationship ending. And I immediately looked for another relationship to fill that void. It was the biggest mistake that I made and caused me so much more pain long term than if I had just done what I needed to do up front and taken the time for myself and just gone through the pain at that time. So what I want to talk about today is why it's not a great idea to relationship jump. And you might think that it's a super good idea because it takes away the pain, and it does. However, tip number one is that regardless of when you choose to deal with the pain, you have to deal with the pain. The pain is going to be there. You can camouflage it and you can mask it all you want in a new relationship later, or you can do it sooner. But eventually, you have to do the work in coming to terms with the ending of that relationship. And if you don't do that work, what you have to try and mull around through with that new person in your life is the anger, is the resentment, is the blame, it is the shame, it is the guilt, whatever feelings and emotions that are left unprocessed. If you don't do the work beforehand and you jump right into a new relationship, then you're bringing all of that emotion and all of those feelings with you into your new relationship. So that new relationship doesn't even have a leg to stand on because you're sorting through all of your own baggage in that new relationship. The other part of that is that you end up with a lot of very short-term disappointing relationships if you were a relationship jumper like I was. And that in itself really threatens and depletes your self-confidence and your self-esteem. And you're like wondering, like, why can't I just find a good relationship? Well, you can't because you're not good within yourself. So tip number one is deal with your stuff, deal with the pain, deal with all of those feelings and emotions before you even entertain the thought of getting into a new relationship. And that sets you up for success. And it also sets up the other person for success if they are looking for a long-term relationship as well. And you're not attracting people who are energetically at the same place that you are, because energetically, if you are not feeling good and whole about yourself, chances are you are going to attract somebody who is not feeling good and whole about themselves. And that's just not, you know, a match made in heaven. I'm sorry. That's the truth. Okay. So tip number two on why you don't want to relationship jump after a significant relationship ends is because when we've been in a relationship with somebody for a period of time, we become really intertwined in our lives, and we don't focus so much on the things that bring us joy and happiness and satisfaction and fulfillment on a personal level. We are more about what is it that brings us joy and happiness together as a couple. So when you start that whole detaching process, you have to relearn what types of things make you feel good, what brings you joy, what makes you excited about life, what part of you do you need to work on. You know, let's say your health and fitness is a really good example. A lot of people like really zone in and focus in on their health and fitness after the end of a significant relationship, because oftentimes that's one of the things that kind of falls by the wayside. But Everybody knows when you're eating well and when you're exercising and you're taking care of yourself, mind, body, spirit, and soul, you actually start having more joy in your life and you feel more inspired to do things and to learn new things and to do more of the things that you used to love doing. My little quick note sheet just dropped here. So it's really important to take that time for yourself. There we go. Okay. So it's really important to take that time for yourself to reconnect with that part of you that you may have lost in the relationship. So that was tip number two. Tip number three, and this is a biggie, is we don't take the time. If we relationship jump, we don't take the time to look at who we were being in that significant relationship. And this has everything to do with our patterns and repeating that same cycle of patterns over and over and over again. But you probably have a pretty good idea of what your pattern might be based on the experiences that you're having in your relationships. And if you jump from relationship to relationship, you're not looking at who you are showing up as in your relationship. Are you one of those people who is constantly overgiving of yourself so that the other person is going to like you more? Is that one of your patterns? Are you one of those people that like to show your love and appreciation through money, but can't really back it up with a lot of emotional sturdiness and actually showing up in the relationship? Is that one of your patterns? So those are just a couple of examples, but we will keep having the same experiences in our lives if we don't take the time to recognize who we show up as in our relationships and what is not working about that. So that is really important on our journey to finding and having that healthy, connected relationship that I know everybody wants to have. So that's tip number three on why you don't want to relationship jump. So the last point that I have for you is you don't take the time when you relationship jump to really look at your values, your standards, what it is that you want at this particular point in your life. So for some people, for some women, they want to have kids. Maybe they're in their 30s and maybe they've left a significant relationship and maybe they're at that place in their life where they're ready to have children. And maybe one of the reasons their relationship broke down is because the person that they were with really wasn't into having children, really wasn't into getting married, really wasn't ready for that level of commitment. But maybe you are, and right now that is what you want. And as we go through each stage of our lives, and usually in generational stages, but not exclusively to it, there we have different needs and different wants. You know, an older person might want to create more financial stability, whereas a younger person might just be all about the fun and the travel and the excitement. And somewhere in between, it might be about the marriage and the family and so on. So things change, right? So when we leave that significant relationship, if we jump to another relationship, we're not taking the time to figure out, like, what is it that I want? What is it that I need? What is it that's important to me? And also, another key piece to this is, what standard have I been settling for? And what am I deserving of? So sometimes in relationships, we get caught up in settling and tolerating things that just don't work for us. And we devalue ourselves and we lower our standards. So taking that pause before we move into a new relationship is going to allow us to do some internal soul searching, which is never a bad thing, to reconnect and redefine, like, okay, where am I in my life? What is it that I want? Do I feel I deserve to have any of that? And what types of things do I need to clear from an old pattern, an old belief system that is preventing me from having that. So these are really four important and I feel significant points to why you don't want to relationship jump after the end of a significant relationship. And, you know, honestly, at the end of any relationship, it is always a good time just to take a little bit of a break and reconnect back to yourself, because you are bringing yourself into that next relationship. And if you want it to be good, you got to be good in here first. You can't expect somebody else to make you feel good in here. So I hope you've enjoyed this video today. I would love to hear your comments. Leave your comments below. I read every single one and I will respond to every single one. I so appreciate your likes and your comments. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for supporting me and my channel. And thank you for being here. Have a beautiful day. Sending you tons of love.